I'm in from Murfreesboro to talk about some of the challenges that are faced by the Islamic population in the state of Tennessee, especially some of the more recent items that have dealt with the Tennessee General Assembly. Let's talk about the General Assembly in reference to this.
We said we have a law in place, a federal one, and I want everyone to know that the Muslim community wants this country to be safe. Mm. We decide to live here, and we express happiness becoming American citizen, and we are proud of our country. And when we say our country, I mean America. And some people try to ease the pain. The Muslim community going through by saying they know discrimination exists in America with the African community. And I am quite optimistic about the future, because the anti-Muslim movement in America will go in the same place in the history with the anti-Semitic and the African-American and the anti-Catholic. It will go to the garbage.
Because it's wrong.
Yes, absolutely. While someone is saying this religion teaches this or that, I think we have to talk to the people within the religion. If you have any question about Islam, we welcome this, and we invite people over any time they want. And even though we have a hectic schedule, but we try so hard to respond to each email we receive. People has to realize that when they talk saying they know Islam is bad religion, so many Muslims suffer. I don't mind adult going through difficulty. I can deal with it. But why do you want to allow kids to go through this? I said before, when a child comes to me and they said, why do they hate us?
Okay.
So what would you say to him, Dr. Haley? What would you say to him? Why do they hate us? We did not do anything bad. People said they don't because they just terrorist act coming within the Muslim community. It comes from each community. What did you do in Tennessee? What did we do in Rutherford County? We did not do anything. For someone to say, and the Muslim and non-Muslim community were living fine in the Middle and the Far East. I think we must expect a better life in America because of our standard here in America. If anyone wants to talk about Islam, he is welcome to come. They often say Islam does not allow any freedom of practice, even though it's been said clearly in the Holy Quran that you have your religion and they have theirs. You have the right to practice any religion, and I have the right to practice my religion. Islam taught us to respect other people's religion. This is why Islam allow us to marry from the non-Muslim community, to share with them their food. And this is why the Prophet, peace be upon him, did have very much an agreement with the non-Muslim community, the Jewish community in Al-Madina, a name of a city in Saudi Arabia, and the Christian community in Abyssinia, when he sent a group of the Muslims there. And this exists in the history, no one can deny it. But it seems like people will say, God said in the Holy Quran, kill the non-Muslim. Probably he is right. There is a verse said this, but we have to understand the context.
Okay.
And is this verse was being revealed in the time of the war, while the Prophet was responding to someone? Muslim must not have no right to initiate any war against any nation. They have the right, though, to respond to any act toward them. And we have this right as well. While people say Islam allow honor killing, no. Give me any verse from the Holy Quran allow this? No. Islam does not allow the killing of anyone. And God said in the Holy Quran, taking care of any life soul is mandatory. It's mandatory for me to take care of you because you are a human being like me. It's mandatory for the Muslim to take care of even animals and to clean the street and to do their very best. Are the Muslims all perfect? No. Obviously, they are people. They are not angels. But I can claim that the majority of them are fine. Like the majority of the Christian people are fine. The majority of the Jewish community are fine. If the majority aren't fine, we could be in a mess. The majority are fine. And why don't you give the Muslim community a chance? Get to know them. If they are good, deal with them as a good people. I said before, if anyone, Muslims at least, decide to do anything bad, I will be the first one to report to him to the Homeland Security or the FBI. But I think it is radical in Tennessee. Not Muslim. They are non-Muslim radical in Tennessee. And no one is talking
about
them.
To single out the Muslims.
Yes. We are the one been very much terrified. We are the one being hurt so much. Well, people vandalized the our site twice.
You when know, let me try to get this in over the last 5 minutes. I've heard it said, I've had many opportunities to talk to Dr. Al-Hadid and others, that the terrorist movement has sort of hijacked, in a real